Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to part 9 of Let's Play Crash Bandicoot Warped. To do a quick recap, in part 8, we did level 10 Midnight Run, and then, to finish off the second warp room, we defeated Dingo Dial, the second boss of the game. And also, we returned to the hidden warp room to do level 27, which was the yellow gem path for level 7, Hang 'em High. So yeah, we got a lot done in part 8, and now that we have two warp rooms out of the way, we can now move on to the third warp room, which is right in front of us. 5 new levels for us to explore. And we will start with level 11, Dino Might. So here we go.
Well, haven't we gotten far for a pair of fuzzy marsupials? I am Dr. Nefarious Tropy, master of time and creator of the very time twister machine you see before you. Uka Uka and Dr. Cortex have sent me to end this little charade, so you won't be leaving my area with the crystals. I swear it.
Now, that is Entropy. He is the third boss of the game, but we won't be facing him for a while. So anyway, here we go. This is level 11 Dino Might, the second and final dinosaur-themed level. And as I'm going through here, I'm just going to point out right now that this commentary is post-commentary. I'm not playing the game right now as I'm recording this commentary. I did do live commentary, but for some reason, the commentary wasn't syncing up with the video. I don't know why, so this is post-commentary after I've played through the game. Anyway, you see those weird fishes that look like Crash. I always find them kind of weird. I mean, they even do the tornado spin. Are they supposed to be like some ancient ancestor of Crash that hadn't evolved yet or something? I don't know, but they're kind of weird. Anyway, you see a yellow gem platform right there, but I don't jump on it right away. I go ahead through this first section, but I will come back to it. Don't worry. That gem platform appears after you get the yellow gem in Hang 'em High in the hidden warp room. And right here, I find an animal that Crash can ride. This is a baby Triceratops. And I don't know if he has a name or not. I don't recall ever really being told what his name is. If the T-Rex has a name, somebody please let me know. I'll appreciate it. I'd like to have as much information about these games as I can. Anyway, the T-Rex, he doesn't have any form of attack that I know of other than jumping on enemies. And he has a very high jump. It's at least as high as Crash's double jump. And it proves to be very useful when clearing obstacles. Anyway, I get through the first section, but as you can see, I hop right back on so I can go back to the start of the level and get to the yellow gem platform. So basically, it's me trying to retrace my steps and be careful of the lava pits and whatnot so that I don't get killed. So yep, like I said, this is post-commentary. I'm not actually playing the game right now, because for some reason the live commentary that I did wasn't syncing up properly to the action of the clip. I don't know why, it's just one of the many problems I've had with this LP. Anyway, I get off the T-Rex and go back a little bit farther. And one couple more jumps over the lava pit, and here we go. Get on the yellow gem platform, and this will take us to a new area for us to explore. An area I'm sure most people don't see the first time around, because they probably haven't gotten the yellow gem by this point. But here we go. Gonna knock this off right away, and you see me stepping on these little speed boost sections. They work kind of like the little speed booster things from like the 3D Sonic games. That's the best comparison I can make. Like something out of Sonic. Anyway, there are of course more obstacles than normal. Lava vents, lava pools, the fish, but they're all together not too bad, and we're reintroduced to TNT boxes and crates with metal bands around them, which can only be broken with the Super Body Slam. We haven't seen those really since Gee Whiz. They make their return here for the Yellow Gem area of Dino Might, and gotta watch out with these TNT crates. You would think the TNT explosion would destroy the crates, but they don't. And anyway, I'm gonna go through here, and, oh yeah, check this out. Does this look familiar to anybody? It should, and it's gonna look even more familiar in a minute. I activate this checkpoint, and it's run, run, run for the next 2 minutes. We also have to dodge, grass, lava pools, nitro crates. I hit the lava pool because I didn't get enough distance on my jump. Gotta dodge pteranodons. Oh, this is a horrible section. It is hard. Especially if you're going through for the first time. And right there, I completely jump in the wrong spot and get killed. It won't be the last time I die on this section, trust me. So here I am starting again, and this time I'm using the double jump to my advantage. And that time I basically jumped right into the Pteranodon. I was easy pickings. But don't worry, that's the last time I die on this section, so this is the third attempt. Here's the thing about going through these sections. If you die a lot, yes, it is frustrating, but it does help you learn the section, which can be valuable. Here we go, the nitro crates. That's kind of a hard section. It was for me for the first time, but I get through it without any problems, get the gem, hit the green exclamation point box, which destroys all the nitro crates in the entire level. And right here, I was checking to see if there was actually anything beyond there, but nope. Nothing else to do here, so I get back on the platform, and we are taken back to the main level. So we can continue where we left off, do a body slam, destroy all the crates, get the crystal, which basically marks the halfway point of the level. We're almost done. And as you can see, under those steel crates right there, there are normally nitro crates, but since I already blew them all up, we don't have to worry about them. And right here, here's the bonus stage for this level. Now, the third warp rooms, it's around the third warp room, the levels start to get a little bit more difficult. The challenge is amped up a little bit, which you would probably expect. But anyway, a lot of metal banded crates on this bonus stage. You get to use the supercharged body slam to the fullest in this section. I am trying not to be stupid and fall into the pit like I did in back in Tomb Time. That bonus section was just terrible. We're gonna have to go back to Tomb Time anyway to get the gem. So anyway, and once again, return of the Triceratops, and this is the final stretch of the level with more speed boosts, pteranodons, and lava pools, and volcanic vents, all sorts of crazy obstacles that we have to avoid. Jump. Let the Triceratops get the crate, like you should do in Boneyard. Get the gem, and we are out of there. So yep, Dino Might is done. The main stuff anyway. Crystal, gem, and gem. And of course, we have to watch the victory dance. Although Crash deserves it this time after what he just went through. But anyway, That was Dino Might, and right here I'm checking the percentage. We're 37% through the game at this point. And I was going to try and do a second level, but I looked at how much time had passed and I realized that we weren't going to have enough time to squeeze in another level. So, yep, this is the end of part 9. Stay tuned for part 10, ladies and gentlemen. Ultimate Lifeform RB out.